I want to know the committee and second the fees. I'm still looking for my 12. It's not nice since I've over 4 days, obviously. Our 3 days, I'm still looking for my 12. If you are holding on to something that is not yours, please kindly return it. I don't like it. Thank you.
She wants to remember when it was
her. If you heard Chibumi, your committee, please indicate.
See what I'm saying.
You don't pay attention. You are the committee head. I mentioned somebody in your committee. You didn't pay attention. So how would you even do in your committee? How would you even do you're supposed to work with? So please just pay attention. Chibumi, I think Therefore, please, somebody talk to me about. You don't know. And you sit in your bag. Please indicate, I took this thing, you're looking for it too. So that there will not be conflict, there will not be argument. But if you hold on to something that is not your own, and you don't tell anybody, they will label you as what you are not. Do you understand? So please, let's check our stocks. If you have anything that does not belong to you, you know you can carry comics out. Anything that does not belong to you, please return. Be it sneakers, be it socks, be it towel. Thank you. So for...
Please, black sneakers,
Hold on. Side talks, please. So we can leave here on time. So not do this again, you are done. So not do this thing again. Please.
I mean, I know there's a serious problem, my God. Now, I want to react to some things. Chimuli, your town might not be with anybody. Do you understand? It might just be somewhere. Now, if you go upstairs to that space where we keep our boxes and our stuff, you see that everything is scattered. And then that brings me to the next thing I want to talk about. Please. I understand that some of us are careless, not intentionally. I'm also guilty of that sometimes, and then I remember, even as I'm sitting here, I know I said nobody should leave clothes in the bathroom anyhow, but as I come downstairs, my clothes still be upstairs, and now I remember. You understand? But please, immediately remember that, okay, you put something somewhere that is not supposed to be, please go and pick it up. And then, you take someone's clothes from where they are and you change the position because you probably want to use that space. Please do not forget to return it when you are done. Personally, I hate it when I come and I see my stuff somewhere else. When I was in school, growing up, if I keep this bag here like this, I come back and see it like this, I'll be pissed off. It's not in another position, but it changed. Someone kind of moved it, and then I get pissed off. You understand? That's me. But now I have
changed.
Kind of changed. You understand? I don't get angry like that anymore. But please, let's try. Remember where we keep our stuff and return other people's stuff. Thank you.
Sorry.
Jess.
Where's your size?
Calm down. She had the number, so please. Listen, side talks. Listen, somebody's talking, you listen.
Good morning. I think we're passing it, but I just want to add a little thing. Please, if you see anyone screw from the floor, just speak. It's not nice stepping on someone's foot.
you see someone's store, you are stepping on it because it's not yours. It's not right. Because it's not yours doesn't mean that you should not keep on stepping on that person because you step on it. It's not right now. You see someone's clip on the floor, even if it's bamboo, we saw like yesterday, I picked about three things. I don't know who has it. I had to keep it on Jimmy's corner. But when I came back, I didn't see it there. That means the owner went there and saw it and picked it. So if you leave it on the floor, it's not right. Even if it's your and it gets missing, you get upset. So please, you should just try. Because me, if my clothes should fall on the floor, even if it's something I want to wear, I will not be able to put it on again. So if you see someone's clothes on the floor, just kindly pick it up. Keep, if you don't know the person, just you can place it anywhere. Person come and see, the person will collect it. And don't step in on another person because step on the ground, it's not your own. That's selfish.
Thank you. Thank you. T-boy. So please, as you are saying, be fast. So we can
show.
Be fast.
What did they say about Sonny?
Thank you. Who's the next person? Talk.
Yeah, I just want to say that the management, they should try as much as possible to help us with our laundry. They are taking our dirty
clothes.
They are taking much time to like wash and bring it back for us.
Side talk.
This one I want to say is very, very important. Somebody just did it in the morning. I mean, this morning, and it's not right. Please, let's respect our NHOH. When I was climbing this upstairs, I noticed that rats die inside that floor place. Then I called my attention, but I don't think whether help me or not. Collect air fresh from general so we can spray it around this.
Then I was upstairs when I heard it, when somebody was calling, Janara, please, we need air fresher. Directly. What is the work of this man? That means we are not respecting him. Please, it's not right. Not everything we ask direct. We can't even ask anything direct. That's not fact anything direct. He's here to answer us. When you are doing it direct, the other will be thinking that you don't know his work. Please, it's not right. And moreover, those in charge of toilet, please don't forget his wisdom. I love you so much. The cleaner is wisdom.
Thank you.
Last
three.
Every
day I enter and I see pee inside and not flush it, I will not do it. Let me tell you for now. Because people will pee, people will not flush. Any day I enter, I see pee, I will not touch it.
What I'm trying to say is concerning the way we use bottled water here. I myself, let me be honest with you, I don't buy bottled water all the time. I can only buy it when maybe when I'm going for party or maybe when I'm in the bus and I don't want to drink pure water. You hear? So if I'm the one at home, I wouldn't be wasting money buying the bottled water.
Let him talk.
I want to bring a way we can handle it if that particular bottle water. I know sometimes we do forget. Me myself, sometimes if I see bottle water I have, I wouldn't know who the men it. I believe you guys are healthy. So I will drink it. Because if I'm in the jungle and I'm thirsty, whatever thing I see as a water, I will drink some. People drink their piss when they're in the jungle and they don't have any. So you will not come here and be claiming, I will drink this or I will drink this. So I try to save the water. Sometimes I'm not even hungry for water, but I don't want that water to use. I will drink. So you can actually keep it beside. Hello. You can actually keep it beside your bed. So you can come back later and pick it from there if you are drinking crap out.
Stand.
So what, that's it. If you are drinking half half, please go and drop it beside your bed so you can come back there and pick that same half and finish it, that half here tomorrow. You yourself will not remember where you drop that half again.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Any other person has something reaction anything? So that to answer something. So now about your for those that want to cut their hair and shave and length, he said he will get back to us. So let's wait for our tax master or tax director. Then for the shoes, he said we should bring our shoes downstairs to the lobby. Now it still rings at this time, would you get? So there's no definite time, or there's no definite space to spread your shoes. Do you understand?
Yes.
We can bring your shoes down to the lobby, which is this corridor here.
Yeah.
Bring your shoes down there. If there is sun, they'll take it out for us. And when it rains, they bring it back inside. That way, the rooms don't smell. So if you know that, if you know your shoe is wet and it's upstairs, you are wrong. Do you understand? Do we understand? Because
yes.
I've seen it now. If your shoe is upstairs and it's wet, and you don't have to be smelling, you are wrong. Please bring them downstairs to the lobby. When there's sun, they dry for us. Same as your clothes or your towel. But I don't think that's I won't advise the towel anyway. He said we should bring it downstairs and do the same thing. But I don't advise that because it is clothes, it will smell. If there's no sunlight, you now leave inside the pocket, inside bag, it doesn't make sense. So for your clothes, just find a way to dry it somewhere. I don't know. I just find a way to just maintain jigget. But for the shoes, it's better. Bring them downstairs and keep them at the lobby. You know your shoes. When you want to use them, you come back downstairs, pick your shoes and wear them. Then what else? So for the rooms now, henceforth, trash bags are provided for every room for trash. On no account should you drop rubbish or trash on the floor. Let's listen now. On no account should you eat anything or drink anything and throw it on the floor. Trash bags will be in every room. If you're in somebody's room, you eat something, you pick it. Trash bag. If you drop it on the floor, it doesn't make sense. Yes, no, then we don't need to start, sorry, please sit down. We don't need to start punishing ourselves or start saying that because they're the man, if you don't punish, it doesn't make sense. We are adults. We let be like adults as we are. Eat anything, drink anything, go to the trash bag and drop it. Please. I think I've answered. Okay, now for the food, very good for the food. I think what. Talking about food here. So, what's about food? Idea. Okay, now for the food. I personally will not support that we serve food in different places because the dining table is not big enough and I don't think there are extra places. It's not the place enough to 60 or 62, so we can't cover them. Do you understand? So I don't think we should do that. Rather, I think what I will not be so extreme and follow what you said to you and say that because we didn't come on time, we should not eat. As much as we are in a camp, one of the things that we promised was comfort, right? They promised us comfort, and that means you have right to your meal. What we are saying that you should be disciplined and understand that people that are in this house also came here for the same reason that you are here. So nobody's here to serve you. People are doing it voluntarily. Do you understand? So, if you cannot come downstairs at the time to eat your food, as I said before, tell somebody, I beg, let me collect my food. And if the people that are left are like maybe 5 or 6, that the table can contain and it's still presented, then they can now do that. Do you understand? Then they cannot serve the food and cover.
Yes.
Because it's just 5 or 6. The place does not look so messy. But if you like 20 people, it don't make sense.
Yes, sir.
It don't make sense. Then for timing, I love what you said. Thank you so much. Thank you for that contribution. So, as I said, let's find the appropriate time to do our cleaning. Then baby Tuti, right?
Yeah.
You talk about you not eating, you know, not being able to eat after workout. So after the workout, if we quickly go and clean before we eat, we will not die.
Do you understand? You don't go there. Most of us don't eat 7 a.m. or 8 a.m. in our house. Let them go like that. But Juliet, we don't eat that time. So please, as I said before, let's look out for each other. For our sake. Let's listen. For our sake. Immediately after aerobics, everybody to your corner. Andrew, your corner. And then once you are done, you know, committees can take over from there.
Do you get?
Yeah, committees can take over. So for committees, I don't know, you guys should talk to your people and know how you want to arrange yourselves and work. After hitting your corner, committees can take over, then you can go and eat your big fat, put it out to eat. You don't think they are bad, they do that. Do you understand?
Yes, do we understand?
What else? Then for the laundry, before now, I think they've answered this question. But I understand people's plight. So I will still talk to General and Tax Director. But he said that they will handle the laundry on Wednesday. Do we remember he said that? I think what he said was they take to handle the laundry. Maybe, I don't know, maybe they will come up on Wednesday. One day, I don't know.
Before we are talking about, not even this one.
Listen,
some of these challenges are challenges we can simply solve without even stressing or overthinking. Now, the laundry we are talking about, like drying here, this space also is too small and is an entrance to the house, so for me, I won't support that. But we have a big space out there, the arena, that we are not using, sir. In our houses, in our place, we use industrial fan to dry our clothes. That's a very big space there. See, behind it, because I know the answer might go there, but they might want to be an answer that, oh, there's a camera there watching the place. But behind the camera will not see that place. So if we get a rope, there's a rope that's removable. Whenever we are coming for activities, because that place is empty, nobody uses it.
Where? How many fans are there?
Wait now.
Where?
Hear what it's I'm saying. I said, if they give us an industrial fan, you can put your, my own, I won't dry my stuff there because I have a way of already doing my stuff. But I'm saying for all of us, these things you are talking about is not for me. But sometimes you take this, so instead of giving your clothes for 3 days, the small clothes you have to dry, your singlet and all that, you put it there, they give you a rope, you put an industrial fan, so I know, that fan before 1 hour, 2 hours, will get those stuff, so you can go there and pick your stuff, like those that want to dry on your towel. Yes. Do you understand? So the room would not be smelling. That would have solved our problem of smelling. Not of smell.
Side talks.
If you look down, sir, there's one fan, there's something like that, the bigger one, that's what I'm talking about. So just get the rope. Whenever we are going for activities, where camera will now be looking at each point, we take the rope off. When we are done, we tie it back. It's simple to solve that problem. That's still managing space and time, and everything will go well. So we can make that request, sir.
I will talk to them. Any other things?
No, we need to sleep, so we got to
do. So please, I beg. Committee, you guys should meet up now. I address this.
Report to the lounge. the lost mate. Oh, hail the king. Hello, King. You are brave. Be seated. I will say this. As long as you are in my mansion, cooperate and try to work with the king, because you might be the next king. Your contributions and suggestions, fantastic one. I want you all to listen to yourselves. You all made a good point. That is why, when you go for any platform like this, the first place you get connected and learn is yourselves. Because that person sitting close to you might just be that person that will take you to the next level. So, you respect everyone's opinion. Connect with one another. I know you are here for a serious business. And you have to know you're here for a serious business. Just as G29 said. You know what you came here for. And when you miss your meal, it doesn't mean you should get distracted. When you're focused, you know where you're going. Food cannot be an hindrance or a distraction to you. Hello, housemate. This is your task for today. You all will individually give a 5-minute monologue of a story of your choice. you all. Individually, we'll give a 5-minute monologue of any story of your choice. What I will be looking at is one, interpretation. Two, the message. Three, the concept. Four, suspense. Then five, creativity. Take place 4 p.m. this evening. Mate. I overheard one of you saying that the tax that was given to you yesterday your performance was depend on lack of time. I tell you, when you channel all this energy to using gossiping and making noise into the few minutes given to you for your tax, you will come out perfect and bold in your presentation. And your delivery will be excellent. When you're giving a tax, I expect you to get serious with it. While you are here, you're here to build yourself. So when you leave this place, you will take the industry to the next level. the winner of this tax will be rewarded as usual. Is a tax of the mind. At 30 PM today, we will be having our fashion show. That is going to be cross-gender fashion show. So the girls will be dressed by the guys, and the guys will be dressed by the girls. The guys will walk on heels. Hello, housemate. For the guys, after your tax, 4 p.m. today, I will advise you to start rehearsing on how to walk with heels. Because many of you will fall on stage. And that will be a minus for me. Do you understand? You're hereby dismissed. Hello, housemate. JFK. JFK.
Yes, sir.
Why not try?
No, my feet is even okay. I can fit into most of the heels. I'm just worried about this beautiful guy here.
Speak up.
I said for me though, my feet is okay. I'm just speaking because I looked around immediately. You said that I looked around and I see a lot of big foot. Yeah, so
and what makes you feel most of the ladies in my mansion don't have big foot? So you're busy observing my ladies' legs. JFK.
Yes, General.
You are not here to do the conventional, but you are here to do the unconventional.
Because I'm very unconventional, sir.
So, there was a need for asking the question you're asking. Be seated.
Okay, sir.
General, sir. King. Speak up.
General, we said we have 5 minutes for our monologue. Are we to elapse the 5 minutes or we have to work within the 5 minutes?
and you're given a time. Did you elapse that time? I said 5-minute monologue. It means your monologue should be either 5 minutes or before 5 minutes. But it should not be less than 4 minutes. So if you think you want to come and present for 1 minute, make sure your monologue is up to 4 minutes. Minimum 4 minutes, maximum 5 minutes. Hello, housemate. You hereby dismiss. This is the general. The next time I see any housemate without his tag, except JFK, I will issue a warning strike. Take note.
One thing that crosses my
I get 200 for them, even if I get low marks, I push them. They must give me admission.
People call it pay. They call it pay, they call it bring, they call it teach them. People come to pass, people get
295. So
I can't stand where Ladies.
Noella Summer. Solution.
Shey?
Yes.
Where you are?
I'm coming. I'm here.
Like
Yeah. I'm going to go to the hospital. Amulet. today, I am not going to write a letter. But well, your chance, your rest, for God. Today, I am done. Yes.
You're
going to write. You are going to write.
No, this one, you don't look happy now.
I want to forget that.
No,
okay.
for my dear tomorrow. I will first pray for God.
I'm sorry. clear, right?
Yeah.
Don't worry. I'm going to try this one Monday. It doesn't work out well. Yeah. This is not right now.
I'm not sure.